So transformation, nothing but here, transfer of genetic material from one bacteria to the other bacteria, we called as transformation. Okay. So transformation experiments is carried out by the Griffith. So he used one of the bacteria, that is Streptococcus pneumonia. It causes lung infection, that is pneumonia. Fine. So, and he found that something is transferring from one bacteria to other bacteria, but he failed to explain biochemical nature of that genetic material. Okay, so he found that something is transferring from, especially from heat killed S strain to the live R strain. Okay, so there are two types of strains, bacterial strains which are present in Streptococcus. One is R strain, next one is S strain. So R strain produces rough colonies when it grow on petri plate or in the nutrient media. But S strain produces smooth colonies when that bacteria grew on nutrient agar media, okay, or growth media. So why here S strain producing smooth colonies? Because due to the presence of mucus coat or polysaccharide coat, here S strain produces smooth colonies. Okay. And due to the presence of polysaccharide coat or mucus coat, S strain is virulent and R strain is non-virulent or avirulent. Okay. So who performed this one experiment? Who given this transforming principle? The transforming principle is given by Frederick Griffith. Okay. So Frederick Griffith was trying to find a cure for one disease when he performed his famous bacterial experiments. Okay. So especially he is trying to find a cure for pneumonia disease. When he performing the experiments on Streptococcus pneumonia, he's trying to find a cure or to find a vaccine against this bacterial infection. So especially here, Frederick Griffith performed the experiments on Streptococcus pneumonia bacteria. Streptococcus pneumonia bacteria. It causes pneumonia infection. He tried to find a vaccine or medicine against pneumonia infection. So next. So Griffith experiment illustrated a principle where bacterial cell was changed from one form to other. This process is called. So during his experiment, when he injected that heat killed S strain along with R strain into the mice, what happened? Mice was died with pneumonia. So what is the reason for that? Due to the transformation of R strain into S strain, due to the transfer of genetic material from heat killed S strain to R strain. So due to the transfer of genetic material from heat killed R strain to S strain, from S strain to heat killed S strain to R strain converts to S strain and it can synthesize polysaccharide coat and cause pneumonia. Okay. So what is the answer for that? So what is the reason for the conversion of R strain into S strain? The reason is transformation. Transformation of genetic material from heat killed S strain to R strain. So next, Frederick Griffith made his important observation about transformation while attempting to develop a vaccine against which of the following pathogenic organism? Yes, what is the pathogenic organism he used to perform this one transformation principle? That is nothing but Streptococcus pneumonia. He used one of the pathogenic organism, that is Streptococcus pneumonia. So he tried to find a vaccine against Streptococcus pneumonia. And when he performing the experiment by using this Streptococcus pneumonia, he found that transformation of R strain into S strain by the transfer of genetic material from the heat killed strain to our strain. Next. So yes. So when the Frederick Ripley coined the term transformation, so when he performing the experiments on Staphylococcus pneumonia. So here there are two strains which are present in Staphylococcus pneumonia. One is S strain and R strain. S strain produces smooth colonies, and R strain produces rough colonies or petriplet when it is growing on, when the bacteria grow on nutrient abundant media. So Streptococcus here, it is a cocaine. So why it is called as Streptococcus means? So this bacteria appear like a long chain. So here, the Streptococcus is a cocaine. This bacteria in the form of chains. Role of DNA in hereditary was discovered for the first time through the experiments involving. Yeah. Frederick Griffith, when he performed the experiments on Streptococcus pneumonia bacteria, he found that transformation of R strain into S strain due to the transfer of genetic material. Especially, he injected heat killed S strain along with R strain. When he injected this heat killed S strain along with R strain, he observed that development of lung infection in the rats or in the mice. Which of the following steps shows transformation with regard to Griffith experiment? So he used two types of strains, S strain and R strain. So here S strain consists of polysaccharide coat or mucus coat. That's why it is encapsulated bacteria. And for R strain, the polysaccharide coat is absent, that's why it is called as non-encapsulated bacteria. When he injected heat-killed encapsulated S strain and non-encapsulated R strain, he observed that development of pneumonia in the mice. That is due to the transformation of genetic material from heat killed S strain to R strain. At the end of the experiment, he isolated S strain from the mice. So if you see in these pictures, one is R strain that produces rough colonies and S strain produces smooth colonies. So in which bacteria first transformation was studied? That is nothing but Streptococcus pneumonia. So which of the following Streptococcus pneumonia strain is virulent? So that is nothing but S strain, because due to the presence of mucus coat or polysaccharide coat. Next, which of the following Streptococcus pneumonia strain produces rough colonies? That is nothing but R strain, because there is no any mucus or polysaccharide coat present on the surface of R strain. That's why it produces rough colonies, and R strain is a virulent. It do not cause pneumonia. factors. As the strain produces smooth colonies due to the presence of polysaccharide coat, also known as mucus coat. Due to the presence of mucus coat or polysaccharide coat, S. strain is virulent and cause pneumonia. So Griffith infected mice with combination of dead S. strain and live or strain bacterial strains. What was the outcome? So the outcome is the mice will die due to the transformation of genetic material from S to R strain. What is the outcome when mice was injected with heat killed S strain along with live R strain? So mice was dies with pneumonia due to the transformation process. Transfer of genetic material from S to R strain. But what we call that transformation. So Griffith failed to define DAS nature of genetic material. That is nothing but biochemical nature of genetic material. Thank you.